Hello everyone and welcome back to Humankind Extreme Edition, at least a short Extreme Edition in the beta that we have right now. Last episode we managed to grab a couple of territories around us. Some of them are well soon becoming cities, at least once we have the influence for that. We also have a regiment full of Promakoi and archers here, so 4 regiment. I'm really proud of that, to be honest, so early on. The other hand, we are building now the stone circles or the stone rings, our first holy site that we need for our religion. And I would still like to continue with a bit of scouting ahead and stuff like that. So over here, we're pretty much at the end because I know this map quite well now. What I want to do is I would still like to find something here. Perhaps there's still an outpost there that we might get. So this is where I would like to go. Yes, we can do this. It's 100 influence. We can still go for it. No one else has gone for that. The flooded lands, let's adapt to this one. So if you don't know these events yet, I urge you to watch one of my other Let's Plays, because there I'm reading it, but of course at some point they just repeat themselves. Irastar, another one. We're still behind on the fame levels though, right? But I guess it's like in Civilization where they cheat early on quite a lot and get huge bonuses. I have no idea how you get to 1,400 fame points in turn 44, but I guess that's their thing. But I think we're still doing pretty well. Let's go for the outpost in this, grab that territory for us. Not a whole lot of food in here, right? So this one is a pretty bad territory. Not necessarily too bad because it's got lots of industry and marble and I think copper. Yep. So this is what we would go for. Plus, I think it's only an outpost anyway. Let's build it here and grab the territory for us. Belongs to us now. Very good. With the influence. My archers, they can stay here. And I think we should have way more soldiers. Bronze working, we can now exploit copper and the spearmen. So that is something. For my next research, then we can go for masonry is a good boost. Let's go masonry and then irrigation. Irrigation is good because of the public fountain that gives me a huge stability boost, a permanent stability boost to my cities. Okay, let's see what's down here. Oh, there's actually quite a lot. And I'm preparing already for my first war declaration. So, oh, soggy. That event was not successful. So we still really do need more and more soldiers. But for that, we do need more cities. Because cities put out pops. And with pops, we can produce units. We got 5 coin. All right. Not a jackpot, essentially. Let's continue to the next one. Point of interest. And already classical era. Boy, they are fast. This one here, I would really like to go for for city, but we do need a bit more influence. I can now go for the copper. Let's exploit the copper that we have there. And does this here... Nah, with this we wait. I mean, I could get the sage. This is more stability. Or the horses. 10 rounds? Let's go for that. 10 rounds. And down here, this outpost. Oh, this is looking good. There we have obsidian, that's industry and stability. And marble, that's industry per worker and stability per marble. Let's go for that. Really good resources that we have there. Now, Mykene is ready for something more. Let's build another Promakoi. Let's build 2 of them, in fact. And then I would like to go with some farming, because we want to push out units, and farming is increasing my growth. We have a farmer district. Building another one next to it gives me the adjacency bonus that I want to achieve. Okay, down here with my units, what should we do? This is the end of the world. Let's get back up again with my regiment, which is called a hunting party. Ah, very good. Another pop that we gained. That's important because every unit is consuming a population in a city. Oh, and something bad happened. The war between the Huns and the Persians has ended. So that is what's happening over here. There we have the Huns and there we have the Persians. And the problem is if they are no longer at war with each other, they might focus on us, right? So, yeah. That's something where we need to be careful. Can we attack them without a war declaration? I think we can because they're in our territory. Okay, they're fleeing. I've got my next unit. And Asa has gained a population. And we've also got a star because we have gotten another population. And we need one more pop and then we can go for the next era. Let's finish the horse ranch. So I'm going to purchase it with coin. Because we can now go with the city creation. And that is more important to start this one. 17 turns. Those units can stay here now. Very important to stay here because I think there might be a war at us. Oh my goodness. Are you trying to attack me now? No idea. Doesn't look so good. Here, we have finished that already. So we could go for the next exploit. Down here, the obsidian. Mykene got a new population, and with that we have reached the end of the ancient eras and we can advance to the classical era right away. We're still last on the list, but as I said, it could be that they are cheating so hard like in Civilization, so early on they get all these bonuses and you will have to, well, catch up with them. The packing of poultry, the art of divination spreads across the empire, priests search for messages from the gods and animal entrails, the flights of birds, the wheeling of the stars, and holy decoctions and elsewhere. Now, however, the practices have become so commonplace, so bizarre, that the whole empire is sliding towards chaotic superstition. Even the eating patterns of chickens are being interpreted by military commanders. Embrace it. We get some stability. Or learn from it with reason, we get some science boost. That's something I like. And new era. Do we have the Romans? There they are, Romans. With them we get the Praetorian Guards. 30 on the power, but it needs iron. Legion's finest triumphal arc. And there's one additional unit slot in each army, and that's the Legion bonus. Let's go for the Romans.
As urban centers grow, both ideas and sewage are generated at a record pace. Arts and sciences flourish as military tactics and mathematical equations become as coveted as physical goods. Empires struggle to control these intangibles, however, as some might trouble their stability.
Alrighty, classical era. And we are now the Romans, so no longer some other one. So we might call the capital now Rome instead of Mykene. That might be better. The outposts are still called Romans, so they get their name then once they become a city. This one here still takes 14 turns, and a third city that I would like to get, we should be able to have then soon as well. Now it's still all about the iron. We are in the masonry right now. Going for iron is over here, the standing army. So this is the one that we should go for. That takes after that, right? So we finish the masonry first. New population. Thank you very much for that. We're expansionists now. Focusing on expansion. Can instantly purchase adjacent outposts or attached territories. But this is annexation. So that would be hostile. Of course. Okay, they're not trying something here. There's more copper. Let's take the copper. And then what else do we have here? Oh, more marble. Marble is always good. And it's pretty much the only thing we can do as an outpost. Build those artisan quarters. Rome has something. We could have the triumphal arc now. Gives me the influence bonus and the stability bonus. It's actually pretty tempting. Or we continue with the military units. We have not a spearman thanks to having copper. Spearman from McCoy. It's a difficult decision. Or we boost our food income, right? So the food per farmers. Also the food per horse and the food per farmer quarter. And we have two farmer quarters and we have horses. So this is actually pretty worth it. And the more food we have, the higher the growth is, right? And the more growth, the faster units we can produce. So animal barns it is. And yeah, that sage there though, it's not something I really want for now. It's only a bit of stability and we have enough of that. Oh, and the garrison. gives me plus combat strength in combat for units adjacent to the district. Is a land unit spawn, and it's fortified, so this would be pretty good once we know the border to an empire that attacks us. Oh, and the Celts feel different about us. Hate-filled. Oh, and they have declared war. Alright, the first war declaration. Is this the end already? I don't know, should we give this outpost up and move towards the main city again? I know I need more units though. Promakoi, archers. Let's just see what they're doing. They have... How can they have so many armies? Masonry, thank you. Four. Another four regiment perhaps somewhere. I will have to give up this outpost there, unfortunately. There is no way to keep it because I need to move my regiment back home. Plus they are also stronger, their units. In Rome, I could build the palisade as well. Let's build the palisade. Let's build this one now. And then the Promakoi and then the archer. This one is going down. I will move my army away to this city creation up there, right? Because this becomes a city and cities are easier to hold. This outpost here I will have to give up for now. Standing army? Nah, that's not the organized warfare. There's the organized warfare. That is really important. This is actually the most important one now. We need to switch to that. Why? Because this one here gives us the action to use reinforcements. So that means we can combine armies that are standing together to fight. Right now, only the regiments themselves can fight and not the adjacent armies surrounding them. Yep, they're ransacking this. Can't change that now. There is something that, yeah, we can intercept them and kill them. Oh, they're retreating. In a bad area. Here we can take them. And let's destroy them. Okay, we haven't lost anything here. At least they've lost their unit. And very important in this case here is the war score. So the war score, as we can see, if their war support drops so low that they can't do anything anymore, then they would have to give up. So we can win this war still by just, you know, defending ourselves. And we could also claim a wonder. I'm not doing that. Influence is more important than some wonders. We could create the next city. And it's that one here most likely. Oh, wait a second. I could also make this one an attachment. Yes, it's probably going to be an attachment. There it is. So that's an attachment of Rome. And we have finished the palisade and they are now besieging us. Look at that. They're besieging us. So nothing we really need to do for now. I can still send my units. Can I do that? No, I can't do that. All right. Can I build more units? That I can do, I guess. Okay, we cannot join? What is that? Cannot join the Inia. Oh, as long as we don't have the organized warfare. We cannot join this one. That is very strange. They're just besieging us now. They're building now the battering ram. Right, and once they have a few of them, they could attack. We could also, I guess, sortie. So we could launch an attack right away. But we are not strong enough. Now, I'm going to... I could have a counter attack on them and surprise them. But I don't think this will be successful. So no can do. Let's wait here. And I also cannot... train more units. Ah, very strange. This is a mechanic that I don't understand yet so much. We got a civic. And we have two civic points. Very important. Let's have a look. Mercenary armies. Nope. Army composition. This is the one. Professional soldiers. I get plus one combat strength per unit. Really good. And legitimacy. Stability, all right. Or independent people. Nope, let's give me this stability bonus. We need stability at the moment. Defend your flag. What? The siege has been launched. All right, let's try it. There's nothing I can do. So, you know, deployment is within the city compound. And I have no archers. That's even worse. Okay, I would have to go, oh my goodness, yeah, I could do this, right? Yep, attack them from the side. Unfortunately, I don't get a bonus on that. And I think we lost way more units than they did, yep. I have my Promakoi. Unfortunately, I cannot use them here. I can move them over there though, they are much stronger. And the battering ram, nah. Let's end the round. Okay, they're destroying my first units now. But they're taking heavy damage themselves. So far so good. These city sieges are really interesting, but also a bit confusing to me at this point. I can move my next units, but I could also just wait here, right? I could also move that unit over there and attack them here. From the side once again, the stronger units. I've got those guys here, but unfortunately I cannot move up there. Oh, that's not mine. Can I enter the city? Yes. Okay. Let's end this one for now. Okay, they're damaging these walls now too. How is this possible? The wall is closed. How can they attack here? Okay, that one's down at least. They took heavy damage here, I think. It's not looking so good for them. There's another attack on them down there. Very good. Let's end the turn. Okay, since the battle took more than 3 turns, it's a whole new game turn as well, right? So the game is now going into the next the turn. And he's now attacking once again, but I don't think he's got much of a chance here. Attacking now from both sides. And move. Very good. His units are down. It's only his battering ram now. Alright. They killed themselves. And the battering ram. Now, the question is, how can a battering ram do damage to my units? Oh, it can't. Alright. Very good. So, we just need to destroy it now. Strike first. Strike hard. And there we've won! Whoa! That was actually a pretty good fight. And this is ours. We lost 3 units. They lost 5 units. And of course, that is also a big blow to their war score. Right? So it's going down. As we can see, we are going up. If they lose this war, they actually have to give us territory. So that is something. We're building now the cities. This is an attachment. This here should actually also become a city, I think, since it's so far out there already. Let's make this a city and move my armies over there. Oh, we can crush them here too. We should. Let's have an instant resolution there. Perfect. Even though... Now we didn't lose anything. Alright, we can heal our troops. We should be doing that. In the capital, let's move my main army over there and heal them. And of course, we're continuing building more units. Ooh, that was actually pretty stressful, but also fun. Let's just see what happens next. Are they at war with each other as well?
You expect Greece?
Yes! The Celts are at war with three nations now. Oh my goodness. And yet they can still get so many troops out. How is that possible? I'm moving with my armies over there to my becoming city and heal them. So they're fighting against all of them now. We might use this. Can we go with the Persians? Hesitant towards us. Okay. I would like to do anything. They have a grievance with us. What? Oh, because I have this territory there. Oppressing the faithful. Okay, a treaty. Perhaps that does anything. Non-aggression pact. Hey, ah, friend. Very good.
I have a notion yes. Which would benefit us both.
We have a non-aggression pact with the Persians. That's good. That's giving us a little edge there for now. Okay, they're coming in again. Poo. I'm a bit worried here, but so far we are managing still fine, but there are more troops coming in. Stay tuned.